Hi boys and girls.
Do you want to learn something or what?
This episode of Amplified is brought to you by Carbonite.
It's taco time. Rafa, why are you the only one not eating tacos?
I don't want to talk about it.
This is what happens when you get taco stains on your shirt.
Oh, you put some Crisco on that bitch.
I'm cleaning a stain. So I gotta line my nipple up with the stain so it pokes the shirt out a little bit. Where the stain is so I can effectively scrub it.
So today at my shop, me and Rafa are gonna install and tune an Audison Bit Ten audio processor. So we're just gonna give you a little rundown on what we do when we tune a system. We do a lot of these because it's kind of like an essential piece to really make your system sound right. If you don't have a processor or an EQ that's tuned properly, then chances are your system doesn't sound like it's supposed to.
First thing you gotta do is take everything apart and peep out the old install. Then you take off the door panels and run separate wires from the tweeters to the amp.
In this setup, since we're going active, we're gonna have two channels for the mids and two for the tweeters.
Crunching rangefinder! Oops, I broke it.
Hey, why don't you shut the f*** up, you dirty son of a f***. Anyways, So, since these speakers are Panasonic's and I don't know how they sound, and I don't know what the crossover point should be, I'm gonna use a tool that's called the IM-SG, and this is a tone generator that can play pink noise, as well as many other things. So that's gonna play every frequency evenly. So I can measure it with this RTA mic. This is a microphone hooked up to a real-time analyzer. This isn't the ideal way to test the speaker, but it's gonna give me an idea because if the speaker stops producing a frequency at a certain point, I know where to cross it over at. So that's what we're trying to get an idea of. And then we'll EQ it and tune it all later. Here we could tell it stops producing any high frequencies right at 6.3 kilohertz. And then this has got a big old fat peak and a big fat dip, which sucks. Okay, so now we got the tweeter hooked up and we can see it plays pretty decently. And then we got a starts to roll off about 5K. What I'm trying to determine is where I want to cross the tweeter over. So now that I know the mid stops playing at 6.3 and the tweeter rolls off at 5K, so maybe I'll do like 4K and I'll let this naturally roll off and then I'll let the mid roll off. And then hopefully we don't have a dip there, but so we'll go high pass on the tweeter. I'm gonna try 4K first. And then band pass on the mid, because now you're crossing the mid over twice. You're high passing it and low passing it. Because you don't want it to play the tweeter frequencies because you have a tweeter to do that. And then you have a sub to play the lows. So you want each speaker to play what it can play efficiently. So I'm gonna bandpass, I'm gonna start the bandpass at 80 hertz to 4 kilohertz. And then the sub will be low pass, 80 and down. And that should give us like a good starting point for the crossover points. And then we can RTA all that together and then adjust the gains for the tweeter, mid, and sub and get it as flat as we can with the crossover points before we EQ anything.
I think I'll serve us another coffee, please.
Thank you.
it was cold in here that day.
Plug it up because it leaves wherever it's at. That's cool.
What's this?
Oh, because it's just USB?
Yeah.
They have,
Alright. And voila!
What is that?
The natural face?
Yeah, if you don't want it to work, just pull this out. Better not lose it. It's all bad, buddy.
Time for this, but I gotta play with it. Oh yeah.
Sing it, Marcel.
It kind of makes you want to have a hot dog, doesn't it?
This thing looks pretty sick. It's an Android-based radio. It supports apps. It has its own marketplace. So developers are able to design apps specifically for car use on the Android radio. And it's touchscreen. The voice commands are cool. It's pretty tight. It's definitely worth looking into if you're looking for a doubled in with nav.
At least my car will f***ing drive it out of the weather. Yeah, it's probably break down in the f***ing water or something.
Yeah, that's because I have a newer engine than your car. My engine's brand new, dumbass.
Is it?
Yeah.
I've never seen a brand new engine with 150,000 miles.
It's a brand new engine. The other one took a crap and I put a new engine in it.
Yes.
The guts of my Jeep are brand new.
It's called rebuilt, bro, not brand new.
No, it's brand new.
It's not brand new.
No. My dad dropped $5,000 on the new engine.
And your dad got the shaft!
I got your shaft right here.
It's right here, man. It's right here. It's medium.
This is the little rear pan with a suede back pulley. Got a suede backing so it's nice and soft. The iPad. And it just goes like this. Two screws go here and then the clips go over these little tabs. So hold that in. That way when those clips snap into the dash, it's nice and tight. And you can still take it out. It's not super permanent. It's a semi-permanent mount. I gotta grind this. This is still the best way to do this. We get a little home button. And we extend it I actually glue a piece of a Bic pin on there. I learned that trick from Jordan, a little Bic pin eater. And we're just gonna extend it and put a little piece of booger on there. This is the sticky shit from the back of a piece of dynamite. But it works good because you're not gluing anything on your iPad. Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure you stay tuned after the ad and the credits for some outtakes. But first, a word from our sponsor, which is Carbonite. Carbonite is an automatic backup solution for your computer. So if you lose your files, your pictures, anything important you're working on, or if you lose your whole computer, you can go to carbonite.com and re-download all your stuff so it was never lost at all. If you go to carbonite.com and use offer code AMPLIFIED, you will get a free trial, and if you decide to buy, you'll get 2 bonus months. So don't be stupid, back up your shit so when disaster strikes, you don't get the shaft. Amplified is filmed on location at Soundman Enterprises Inc. in Valencia, California, Soundsations in Newhall, California, and Mies Car Audio in Lancaster, California.
Being short and white and midnight to fuck, this is worse than being Mexican.
So,
hey. I don't know why Wishbone doesn't like to buy the right size hats. Always looks like he's putting a magnum on a f***ing little dick. So I always give him a hard time for his hat.
Facial recognition.
Primo enchilada.